Go ahead, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. Good evening and welcome to the City of Fairfax swearing-in ceremony for the City of Fairfax, Virginia, for the Fairfax City Council and the Fairfax City School Board. Tonight is Tuesday, June 30th, 2020. I want to welcome several special guests. First is Rick Harrington, the head of our electoral board, and Gerardia Culifer from the the Circuit Court of Fairfax County, who will be swearing in our school board members. And I also want to thank our council clerk and chief of staff of the city, Melanie Crowder, for her preparation for this evening's program. I'm going to begin by recognizing Mr. Harrington.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. See if I can get this centered. Okay. To all to whom these presents shall come, greeting. This is to certify that at a meeting of the Electoral Board of the City of Fairfax, held on the 22nd of May, 2020, on an examination of the official records deposited in the office of the General Registrar, it was ascertained and determined that in an election held on May 19th, 2020, that David L. Meyer was elected mayor. Janice Miller, Jonathan Stehle, Jr., Yang Sang Yi, So Lim, Joseph Harmon, Thomas Ross were duly elected members of the City Council. And Jonathan Buttram, Carolyn Pritches, Robert Reinsel, Toby Sorensen, and Mitch Sutherland were duly elected members of the City of Fairfax School Board for a term commencing July 1st, 2020 and ending on June 30th, 2022. Witness, therefore, the following official signature and the seal at the City of Fairfax of the Secretary of the Electoral Board. Whoop, let me see if I get my, there we are. Thank you. I won't make it in Hollywood, but I think I've got it here covered. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Harrington. We appreciate the work that you and your colleagues on the electoral board have done. And I'll now recognize our city council clerk and chief of staff, Melanie Crowder.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. If I could ask everybody except the mayor to shut off your cameras. Perfect. Mr. Mayor, if you could please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, David L. Meyer.
I, David L. Meyer.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
That I will faithfully and impartially discharge
and perform all of the duties incumbent upon me,
all the duties incumbent upon me
as mayor of the City of Fairfax, Virginia,
as mayor of the City of Fairfax, Virginia,
according to the best of my abilities,
according to the best of my abilities.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you.
And now I will ask for Councilmember Miller to please turn on your camera. Councilmember Miller, please raise your right hand and repeat after me. Oh, I guess I wasn't, I don't know know that you could see my hand before, sorry. I, Janice Miller.
I, Janice Miller.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And perform.
And perform.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As a member of the City Council.
As a member of the City Council.
Of the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
For the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
And now I'll ask for Councilmember Stehle. Good evening, sir. If you could raise your... one second. Can I see your list? Sorry about that. Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Jonathan Stehle, Jr.
I, Jonathan Stehle, Jr.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And perform.
And perform.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
As a member of the City Council for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
As a member of the City of Council for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Thank you very much, Mr. Stehle. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Next, I will ask for Councilmember Yee. Good evening. Oh, you're muted. There you go.
Good test there. Good evening.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Sang H. Yee.
I, Sang H. Yee.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And perform.
And perform.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
As a member of the City Council for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
As a member of the City Council of the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. Yee.
Thank you.
I'll ask for Councilmember Lim. Good evening.
Good evening.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, So P. Lim.
I, So P. Lim.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And perform.
And perform.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
As a member of the City Council of the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
As a member of City Council of City of Fairfax.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Councilmember Lim.
Thank you.
I will ask for Councilmember-elect Harmon. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Joseph Harmon.
I, Joseph Harmon.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And perform.
And perform.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
As a member of the City Council for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
As a member of the City Council of the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. Harmon.
Thank you.
Thank you. Could I please have Councilmember-elect Ross? Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
If you could please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Dean Thomas Ross.
I, Dean Thomas Ross.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And perform.
And perform.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
All of the duties incumbent upon me.
As a City Council member for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
As a member of the City Council of the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. Ross.
Thank you.
Now I will ask for Deputy Chief Deputy Clerk Gerarda Colifer.
Good evening, everyone. Well, greetings from the Fairfax Circuit Courthouse. We are your wonderful neighbors, and we are so glad to work with you all. And warmest regards from everyone in the courthouse, and congratulations to all this evening. So tonight I'll be administering the oath of office for those elected to the Fairfax City School Board. So I would like to ask Jon Buttram to go ahead and put your microphone on active and your camera on. Great.
Hi.
Hi. I'm going to ask you to raise your right hand and repeat after me.
Yes, ma'am.
I, Jon A. Buttram.
I, Jon A. Buttram.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As member of the school board for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
As member of the school board for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. Next, I would ask Carolyn to go ahead and get your microphone active and your camera on. Hi, Carolyn. And I'm going to ask you to raise your right hand, Carolyn, and repeat after me. I, Carolyn S. Pitches.
I, Carolyn S. Pitches.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
That I will support the United States Constitution of America.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As member of the school board for the city of Fairfax, Virginia.
As member of the school board for the city of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Carolyn. Good to see you. Congratulations. All right, next I would ask, Bob, can you go ahead and get your microphone active and your screen up? Great. Okay. Bob, please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Robert M. Reinsel.
I, Robert M. Reinsel.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
And the Constitution for the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As member of the school board for the city of Fairfax, Virginia.
As member of the school board for the city of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my abilities.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Bob. Good to see you. All right, Toby, can you please put your camera and microphone on? Okay, please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Toby M. Sorensen.
I, Tobin M. Sorensen.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution for the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As member of the school board for the city of Fairfax, Virginia.
As member of the school board for the city of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. All right, we have one last one. Mitchell, would you go ahead and activate your microphone and pick? Okay, great. All right, Mitchell, please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Mitchell A. Sutterfield.
I, Mitchell A. Sutterfield.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As member of the school board for the city of Fairfax, Virginia.
As member of the school board for the city of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. All right, with that, everyone, I believe that's all of the school board members for tonight. So I'm going to deactivate my computer and I'm going to log off and let you continue your event unless there's more to the ceremony. I'm not sure about that.
Thank you so much, Gerarda. The mayor will finish up the ceremony with some final remarks.
Well, thank you, Ms. Culliver, for being part of our ceremony today. We appreciate your participation and your support of our school board. I have a few, for those watching from home, I have a few closing remarks that I would like to share with my colleagues on the council, with the school board, and with our citizens. On behalf of the newly re-elected and newly elected members of the city council and our school board, I thank all the citizens of the city of Fairfax, and particularly those citizens who voted, for the opportunity to serve you and our city. We in our city are most fortunate to have a school board and a city council with a broad range of gifts and talents, both professional and personal, and that they bring these talents to their assignments each and every day. These elected officials share a common commitment to sustaining and affirming all that is good about the city of Fairfax. As your mayor, it is my privilege to work with each member of the city council and school board in finding solutions to often vexing challenges. While we may sometimes hold strongly held views that are different than others on certain subjects, there is a unity of purpose that is transcendent in all of our deliberations and a mutual respect for each other and for our commitment to our fellow citizens. Now, this election was like none other that we've ever had. Our thanks to Rick Harrington, Kurt Chandler, and Lorraine Corey, who serve on our electoral board, and to Brenda Cabrera and her staff, and the election officers who prove that elections primarily conducted through the U.S. mail can be honest and can keep voters safe during an ever-evolving pandemic. Now, the swearing-in ceremony that we just participated in and that many of you witnessed may appear to be perfunctory and rote, but it is truly remarkable. Every 2 years, we choose among our neighbors and our friends, individuals who can make decisions about our future. This change in leadership is done without fear of intimidation and is done openly in a fair and honest election. And we should never be complacent about this. Unfortunately, as we all know, there are places in the world where this cannot or does not happen. So let's continue to keep democracy alive and vibrant for the next generation and beyond. Now, the term that was just concluded was really transformative for our city. The outgoing council and school board can be very proud of the many accomplishments that made the term unprecedented, and here are just a few. We adopted a new comprehensive plan and two small area plans. Now, these are our roadmaps for an improved preferred future, creating greater certainty for our residents and for the investment community. We adopted an affordable housing ordinance that ensures that we will be a more inclusive community and create more equitable opportunities for persons with limited incomes. In transportation, we garnered over $130 million in new funds for projects, and we completed the $43 million Chainbridge Road Fairfax Boulevard intersection after 18 years of planning and several years of construction. And we adopted a new sidewalk policy that will make our city more connected. Fire Station 33, was the construction on that fire station began during this term. It'll be our first new fire station in 45 years. And our fire department received national accreditation. We completed the construction of a new police firearms training center at our property yard to ensure that our police officers and law enforcement have state-of-the-art facilities. We reached a 10-year agreement with the Army Navy Country Club, and that ended 10 years of litigation that had a cumulative legal cost in excess of $500,000. In the West Drive property yard owned by the County of Fairfax, we'll be leaving the city after 70 years, and we're getting that industrial operation out of the city limits and acquiring those 4 acres for future public use. And lastly, the city council continues to support the city's jobs program, working with the LAM Center to create opportunities for the least among us. These are just a few of the very large and significant initiatives that we achieved during the last 2 years. And I give all the credit to the city council and to the citizens who supported these initiatives. But even some of the smaller actions speak volumes about the quality of our life here in the city. We closed the Petland store, and we adopted a new pet sales ordinance that is a model for other jurisdictions in our region, giving voice to pets who often do not have a voice. We opened a dog park at Westmore, at the Westmore school site, and we began a successful composting program to reduce our waste stream. Much of the hard work for all of this is due to the dedication and commitment of our city employees. These persons work tirelessly every day on our behalf, and we are immensely grateful for their service ethic, their honesty, and their creativity and support that they exhibit every day. In the human capital area in the last 2 years, the city hired a new city manager, and we welcome and appreciate all that Rob Stalzer has brought to our city. And thank you, Rob, for your leadership. Additionally, we have a new police chief, a new communications director, a new human services director, a new assistant fire chief for code enforcement, a new historic resources director, a new procurement director. These are just some of the new team that's come to the city to bring creativity and new skills and perspectives. And with respect to our existing staff, they continue to present new creative ideas to make our city operations more efficient and effective. Now, while all of these accomplishments are impressive, we are also facing some challenges that are also unprecedented in our city's history. The COVID-19 pandemic is far from over, and we continue to discern the most optimal choices for moving forward to keep our citizens safe and support our local businesses. And the national demands for greater social justice and equity have found many voices in our city, right in our own neighborhoods and our faith communities and our civic and cultural organizations. The elected leadership has heard these demands for change loud and clear. We will address these calls for equity and change at our planning meeting in July, and we'll create a framework and a process by which we can collectively assess and decide what changes to make, when, where, and how. And as we consider these changes, we must also ensure that what we may do and how we may do it is consistent with our core values as a community. Your elected leadership is committed that as we begin this effort at discernment, these challenging discussions will occur in an open, transparent, collaborative, and respectful manner that is inclusive and reflects the diversity we all affirm. In closing, I want to extend a collective thank you on behalf of all the citizens of the city to Michael DeMarco and Jennifer Passy for their service. Beginning with Michael's work on the EDA many years ago and Jennifer's work on the Planning Commission and subsequently their work on the City Council, they have given us their very best and have left a legacy for which they can be justly proud and for which we will be continually thankful. We have much to do as a community. I invite all the citizens to join us in the next chapter of our self-governance. And let's always remember that when it comes to the City of Fairfax, the best is yet to come. Thank you for joining us this evening, and we wish you good night.